Hey, man, y'all know what time it is, man. Say, man, y'all got that boy Duo on here once again, man, dropping down some good jewels, man, on Real Life Street Stars, man. You know what I'm saying? Part two to this we gonna get a part three to this a part four to this nigga, we gonna make a movie out this nigga, real game being exposed, nigga, on Real Life Street Stars, nigga. Shout out.
Real Life Street Stars, hold on, man. We got them back in the building.
That way, man.
Oh, one of the realest ones. Yeah, one of the realest ones. Coming in with that AS on.
Hey, man.
You better get to it, man. Blessings, bro. Welcome back to the couch, man. You know, it's one thing that, you know, we have this Real Life Street Stars alumni, man, where some fans just kind of gravitate towards certain people, man. And the interview you did, man, if they didn't know who you was, man, bro, your energy from the last interview just turned everything up, man. I think people who even knew you probably personally said, Newberry, hey, even Charleston White came in and said, top five interview of the year. Top five of the year. And that's honestly because you came from a real place. Yeah. And it's like, you know, you're normally quiet in the background, kind of watching your brother back, making sure, you know, shit, but you came from real place, just speaking on the history of West Dallas and just Dallas in general, and really giving some real game.
Real talk.
So yeah, let's do it like this, man. From that interview alone, man, what feedback have you gotten from that interview personally, from either family, friends, or whoever, just, you know, anybody approaching you?
Oh, see, man, I'm gonna be honest with you, man. That shit done shocked the world, man. And it's crazy because how can an interview shock so many people? You know what I'm saying? So when I think about that, and I can go from Detroit. I went to Memphis, man, and I had to walk the our people to their section. But they had a comedian on stage at the time, right? So in the process, I come out the green room and I'm walking through the crowd to get to the section, tell my, you know, the whole crowd just went to screaming Dewberry, bro.
Oh,
I'm
man.
Like, this shit is crazy. Man, I'm talking about everybody screaming Dewberry. I'm like, man, what the fuck? This shit was crazy, right? You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about, so, man, it was so much love, homie. Shout out to QC, too, man. QCP, man. He reposted it and everything, man. You know what I'm saying? And it was all authentic, though.
Yeah, because the caption he said, this shit is too real not to share.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the caption.
I forgot, what was he saying in that clip?
Okay, so it was, I asked him a question about the young generation and how they move. Yeah. And you responded in the way that you responded with a lot of passion. And that clip just shot to the top because you was like, nah, these niggas is killing their partners. They ain't on no revolutionary
facts,
shit.
Facts.
You
facts.
Know what I'm saying?
And like I said, man, what caught a lot of people's eyes and it's all over the world is when I'm speaking about we dealing with a generation that haven't been battle tested, homie.
Nah, at all.
But then people get the wrong misinterpretation when I say battle tested, right? The first thing come to a person's mind is, oh, he ain't had no squabbling matches, or he ain't shot nobody,
right?
That's the first thing, right?
Right.
But they don't understand the game. So it kind of, they don't really understand what I mean by saying being battle tested, right?
Yeah.
Have you left your girl around your partner?
That's battle tested.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Have you dropped some money on the ground around your partners and it came back to you?
Yeah.
Have you, like, so therefore, if you're not testing the people that's around you, then guess what? Man, you don't even know what's around you, homie.
Nah, for real.
You don't even know what's around you, homie.
So let me ask you this. What game would you... Because, you know, again, we don't want to sound like we down, because we older. We don't want to sound like we just shitting on the younger generation or anything like that. What do you see positive in the younger generation?
Man, I see so much positive in the young generation, man, because as I continue to, as I watch this new generation, homie, we sit around and we kind of, I don't want nobody to feel like I'm bashing the new generation.
Yeah.
That's not what's happening. What's happening is that the older generation is starting to get the opportunity to have a voice, that we never really had.
Facts.
Because when you dealing with the industry, what do the industry say? They want, they looking for an artist from the age of 15, 16, 17. And then once they get them the spotlight, they become the OGs in the next 2 years at the age of 19 to 20.
Yeah.
So when they get on all of these major platforms and you hearing their voice, it's like, that shit the truth. How in the fuck is the truth? They ain't even been through nothing yet, homie. They ain't nothing but babies, you know what I'm saying?
Facts.
So now you getting the opportunity, like real life street stars, to get some realized certified individuals on this couch and really speak this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
So I'm not knocking the new generation. I'm just telling the new generation that with the opportunity that y'all have, with the money that y'all receiving, the money that y'all receiving, listen to the game that's coming from the older people, because we fucked up, homie. We fucked up already.
Hey, hey, man, that's one thing you said in the last interview, man. You like, man, listen, I'm fucked up.
Yeah.
I'm fucked up. And some, bro, again, me personally, so many people came from like, bro, that for him to start the interview off like that, that let me know this coming from a real place.
Nah, homie, real life, man.
Now, I got to ask you, man, you just said something, man, because that's a scenario. You said, man, you ain't been battle tested. You ain't never left your homie around your girl. What situation comes of leaving your homie around your girl? And how, if your homie try to shoot a shot at your girl, how does a nigga approach that? Like, what you supposed, are you supposed to confront the girl, confront the partner? Like, who do you holler at?
That's where the game come in at. That's where you gotta figure out what kind of nigga you really is, homie. Because at the end of the day, I let my honey go around these individuals so I can be able to see, okay, you can't trust them around your girl. Oh, damn,
you basically testing them.
Yeah. So you know, one thing about it is, sometimes it's good to not say nothing. Be quiet. Play possum. Act like you don't know. Act like you don't know, because when you start acting like you know, then they gonna start being try to be slick. But long as you acting like you a lame, guess what they gonna do? They gonna do it in your face, homie, because you playing lame. You see what I'm saying? But you gotta know this partner right here, okay, he might be a shooter. He might be a squabbler, but he gonna hound your bitch, man. He's one of them niggas that gonna go try to get at your bitch, man, once you leave. All right?
How wrong is that, do you think?
It's not, ain't nothing wrong with it. This is streets, homie. Damn. This is what people gotta realize that, man, this is one thing people gotta realize about the streets, man. And I'm gonna give y'all this real talk, homie. Man, we act like in these streets, man, that it's not about deceiving each other. We act like all the homies is real niggas. We act like these niggas out here ain't no trying to take you out. We act like every nigga that made it to the top, somebody had to bring them down. We act like that don't matter. Snitching is part of the streets. Robbing is part of the streets. Killing is part of the streets. Disloyalty is part of the streets. Niggas act like that ain't part of the streets no more. Come on, homie. This is real life, my nigga.
So where do you lie? And I just want your thoughts on it. When your partner's talking to a female, and let's say she, you know, she a go live, she a tosser, it ain't a real girlfriend. Do you be like, because my partner had she off limits? Or do you be like, hey, man, when you done, you know, hey, it's all fun.
See, now. That come with, hey man, is that your girl? Nah, nigga, that's just somebody we gonna toss up. Okay, that's what that is. But you gotta make sure that this nigga is not really in his feelings.
The niggas won't tell you. Niggas be lying
about the girls that they be tossed up.
But you gotta watch that.
Yeah.
See, you gotta watch that. Nigga, nah, homie, you in your feelings, because I done heard you say certain things.
Right.
So, And I'm gonna be honest with you, man. Since y'all brought that up, all you gotta do is just sit back and just look at everything that done happened. right? All the wars that done got started, everything done happened. Men and female always be the ones that spark the fire.
Right.
And that's real life.
Bro.
Man, I got a homeboy, man. That nigga used to hustle right in Miami. Made millions of dollars in Miami. Right up under everybody knows, millions of dollars. And I say, man, how did you go way out there and make all this money? You know, you got the Haitians, you got, he said, nigga, I'm gonna give you the game. Keep your dick out them niggas' hoes. Mm-hmm. Keep your dick out them niggas' hoes. You can make $1 billion if you keep your dick out them girls, man.
Why is it so hard for niggas to do that? What's wrong with that? Are we just too sexual, over-sexualized? What's going on?
Man, you got some niggas that ain't never had no pussy until they got some money. Man, you got some niggas that went through a middle school and high school, and them niggas ain't never had no females ride and be on they motherfucking jock until they got some money, man. Say, man, the girls in high school and middle school were looking at them niggas like they was some marks, man. They were mark-ass niggas. So when they got a couple of quarters, man, get what they did. Man, they want to fulfill their fantasy. They want to fulfill the stripper lifestyle. They want to fulfill all this shit they see on TV. They want to fulfill the hip-hop shit that they see. They want to do what they want, homie. They feel like if you go do this, it makes you macho. It makes you a macho nigga, homie. And I'm telling these niggas, like, nigga, I'm not impressed with that shit. I'm not impressed with it, homie. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because, homie, I ain't gonna lie to you, man, I was fucking hoes in the penitentiary.
Damn.
Wait.
Man, I was fucking hoes in the penitentiary, my nigga.
Houseway.
Yeah, houseway.
Say, man, listen, man. Man, say, man, listen. Man, I had hoes got my name tattooed on them, homie.
Damn.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I ain't never had no problem with getting at no bitch, man.
Wait. So I'm just curious, cause we was gonna go through there, but fuck it. Since we're here right now, are you talking about like guards, other niggas, bitches, like
man? Every guard got a nigga when they leave the motherfucking gate.
True.
When they come back inside that gate, nigga, you my bitch. Yeah, you my bitch.
Hey, what percentage of female guards are cheating with an inmate?
95%, nigga.
Damn.
95%, nigga.
What? Is it more so the guards hollering at the inmates, or the inmates just got that game and spin at the guards?
Say, man, listen. The objective of the game is if you see a lame bitch come through there, you hear me?
Yeah.
That bitch don't got no game. That bitch from the country. Man, them hoes from Huntsville.
Facts.
Them country hoes, man, they ain't never been around no city slickers, man.
Facts, yeah.
They ain't never been around a nigga with no stocky body.
Facts.
They ain't never been around a nigga that goddamn he'll sit in front of you, serve some game to you, then he'll start crying.
Yeah.
Man, say, man. Them niggas ain't never been around this type of shit, man.
Yo. Yo.
You hear me?
Nah, hey. No, that's fast. Anyway, that's fast because, you know, prisons are normally in small towns. Country towns. And they work in them little towns.
Shit.
So when them city niggas come through, like, God damn.
Man, these hoes fresh out of high school, man.
Yo.
You got these hoes coming fresh out of high school, going inside the motherfucking penitentiary around niggas that exercise game 24/7.
Nigga,
and guess what? Them hoes broke.
No pension.
Man, them hoes been looking at them videos of them niggas walking around with that money, that jewelry, and them hoes ain't never seen that in real life.
Yeah, facts.
When they go to the penitentiary, guess what a nigga do? Say, what's up with it, man? You know, nigga pull out the photo album.
Nigga.
That is.
Nigga.
Ooh, you had that car? Yeah, that's when I had to Benz right there, man. Yeah, now I had the lack right here. Yeah, nigga ain't had a motherfucking thing, nigga.
Nigga,
that's your partner shit.
God,
you hear me? But the bitch don't know.
Yeah.
The bitch don't know what's happening, man, so guess what? That bitch mesmerized.
Yeah.
She.
Hey, is prison guard coochie better than outside world coochie?
You goddamn right, because you know why? Nigga, imagine going 13 years with no pussy and you finally getting some pussy in the washroom, nigga.
Oh, nigga, it's gonna be quick, ain't it?
Say, nigga, listen, man. Listen, this real nigga shit, right?
Yeah, yeah.
This real nigga shit. I remember I was fucking a white bitch, man, in the washroom.
Ooh.
The bitch pulled her pants down and right here.
Oh, barely.
Nigga, I'm going from the top of that motherfucker to get
I'm
up in
down,
that bitch.
I'm going down that motherfucker.
Nigga, the zipper done scratched the nigga shit and everything.
Real nigga shit.
Man, the nigga trying to get that work
real
in.
Real nigga shit.
Man, what?
Yeah.
Say, nigga. Say, man, no, man.
So wait. What, the washroom is that's the place where it go
man,
down? Or
say, man.
What area is the?
Well, you got different units. You know what I'm saying? You got different units. So with different units, they got different ways, you know what I'm saying, how
you
get down. So when I first got down, I got down inside the cell. You know what I'm saying?
Wait, inside the cell?
Yeah, she was playing the shakedown role, right?
Oh, nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
well,
come
hey,
on
man,
in.
Everybody go to chow, right?
Yeah.
But we going to go from, I'm in 26 cell at the time. That's the last cell on the block.
Yeah.
So you going to start at, you going to tell that pig about, hey, man, I'm finna shake down the cell from 15 down to 26, because these niggas been jacking their dick on me. That's how she playing the role. Yeah, these nasty motherfuckers been up there jacking. I got something for they ass. The picket ball going to unlock the doors. They going to, you know?
Yeah.
Nigga, she going to come straight to 26. And there it was. Oh, nigga, you couldn't tell me I wasn't a man.
Oh,
what?
Man. So, well... Hey, wait.
She staged a fake shakedown again, the twat?
Nigga, that's the game. Nigga, that's the game.
Wait, hold on. And shout out Finesse Kenny, man, because he came through and said he had a prison guard too, but her outside boyfriend found out about it and was threatening to kill him.
Man,
did anybody ever found out about you knocking down one of their females, one of them outside boyfriends?
I ain't heard nothing about it. They ain't told me nothing about it.
Yeah, right.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Because one thing about it is, like I tell any motherfucking female that this here, when you come inside the gates, you mine.
Nigga,
once you go outside them gates, you that niggas.
Right.
I'm not trying to take you from your husband.
Right.
I'm not trying to take you from nobody. It's just that once you come in, we got a relationship.
Right.
Yeah. See, some of these niggas get too caught up with it. They want to goddamn me tattoo the bitch name. And,
right.
Man, no, man, it ain't that serious, man. We just serve. It's game, nigga.
Yeah.
It's game. Yeah, man, that's all it is.
So, man, it's a little reality show called Love After Lockup, right? Where you got girls that target niggas in prison to have relationships, and then they put money on their books and shit like that. Did you see anything like that going on where it's like y'all are online dating people from the outside world?
Nigga, that go on all day.
Damn.
Say, man, nigga, goddamn, they got the pen pal gang. They got all types of shit, man. Because one thing about it is, motherfuckers in this free world, they infatuated with them niggas in the penitentiary, man.
Oh, nigga. Yeah, for real. For real.
99% of them niggas is bullshit niggas.
Nigga.
Straight up.
Nigga.
I'm a bullshit nigga down there. Nigga, I done wrote, say, man, I did 18 years flat. Nigga, I done did 18 years, and I had a female from the world on my team for 18
oh,
years.
Oh, damn.
When I came home,
ooh.
Nigga, I ain't with her no goddamn more.
Goddamn, it's our anniversary, and that nigga gone.
I'm saying, man.
That nigga
So, nigga, I know, say, man, nigga, I had to learn, nigga, I was a bullshit ass nigga, man.
So you, so you just passing time? Just, hey, send me.
Say, man, hey, man.
No, wait.
I'm just passing time.
Hey,
for 18 years.
Hey, I ain't gonna hold you, because we were having this discussion, right? We interviewed Hitman Holler, right? A girl, his girlfriend, was in a home invasion that was meant for him, and she got shot in the head, right?
Damn.
She survived, but he still hasn't married her. So we were talking amongst ourselves, like, is there something that could happen in a man's life that a woman does that makes you feel like you automatically are entitled to marry that person?
Oh, nigga, the new generation, just think about something. Nigga, we don't hear about marriages like that no more.
Never. More funerals than marriages.
We don't really hear about marriages like that no more. Like back in the game, homie. We don't really hear about that no more, homie.
Facts.
Just keeping it real, right? So my thing with marriages is this here, I don't knock nobody to get married, you know what I'm saying? But I'd rather be with a female and we have a bond with each other.
Yeah.
A 5, 6, 7, 8 year bond, that's bigger than a ring to me.
Yeah.
Cause you got niggas nowadays that'll be with a female for 1 year and get married to her, not because of love, not because of none of that, just because I don't want you to go fuck with no another nigga.
Yeah. Nah, that's facts. That's
facts. Let's keep it real, homie.
I'm just trying to like,
Keep it real.
I'm trying to keep the whole spirit down, goddamn.
Yeah. So when you see a lot of this shit go on with these celebrities nowadays, man, just imagine. Man, she was just with this nigga Friday. They was married. Now we hear about they done divorced. Nigga, next 2 months, she married to him. God damn, you don't know this nigga for 3 months.
Nah, facts.
So this shit ain't real?
Nigga, at all.
This shit ain't built on loyalty. Well, now get the fuck out of here, man. I just met you, I don't even know you. We go back to this here. Just like a nigga ain't been battle tested. Man, a lot of these bitches ain't been battle tested out here, homie.
At all.
Square business, homie. They don't know what it's like when you lose it all.
Yeah, you ain't been down in the bottom with me.
No, homie.
We ain't slipping no car together.
But for the girl that was with you for 18 years, you didn't feel like no type.
Damn.
You didn't feel like maybe I should just get engaged? like how did you play? You just straight cut her loose? Like,
no, man. I came home with a man and things just didn't work out, man. I don't know if I Yeah, I tried, man. We stayed together, but I don't know if I just was a penitentiary ass nigga. I don't know. Cause I was, you know, nigga been gone 18 goddamn years.
Yeah.
You know, man, and then sometimes that shit'll fuck with you, homie. You know what I'm saying? Just keeping this shit real, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So then you wanna kinda get out and see certain shit and
yeah.
So it ain't her fault.
It ain't her fault. So I have to ask you then.
It ain't her fault.
When a nigga in the penitentiary gets out, a female who dates a nigga who just got out of the penitentiary, should she expect him to be loyal and stay with just her? Or is this nigga bound to just explore and get out there?
She looking to fail, homie.
She looking to fail.
She looking to fail.
Like, listen. I'm free and I'm out.
Man.
I'm free and I'm out.
She looking to fail, homie. Man, you got these niggas been locked up 20 years, 30 years, getting out now. These niggas don't know nothing. When they finally get exposed to the real life, they get exposed to this real world, they get exposed to walking downtown, they get exposed to doing certain things, and most of all, they getting exposed to seeing so many different honeys.
That's facts.
Nigga, let's be realistic. We used to seeing females with a blue smock on. Man, I ain't gonna lie to you. Man, them goddamn prison hoes bad built like a mother.
Oh, damn.
bitches. Say, man. But get what? Man, you goddamn, you see a fat motherfucking nigga, you trying to knock.
Nigga.
What?
Nigga,
y'all squabbling over that big old bitch. Nigga, what? That bitch built like a bag of a corn chip.
Is all we got. Slim pickings.
I'm just keeping it real, though.
Man,
so you come home and see all these honeys, man, nigga, you going to be like, God damn.
Not for real.
Now, and don't let no honey say hi to you.
Nah, hell no.
Oh, nigga.
Then we got the BBLs now? Like, oh, nah.
What?
Nigga, what's
up? They done had a BBL. Man, these niggas getting out with seeing this BBL. Man,
shit.
Oh, shit.
So I have to ask you, dude, man, what are your thoughts when you hear that, you know, when black people, we go to more funerals than we do weddings.
Man,
what are your thoughts on that?
I'm going to tell you something, homie. It's sad, bro. It's sad. It's really sad, man. And y'all know what, man? That's the reason I got on the internet.
Yeah.
I got on the internet, man, because at the end of the day, man, I gang bang, homie.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And when I gang bang, I gave the shit 1,000%. You know what I'm saying? Damn. Gave it 1,000.
Damn.
Gave it 1,000, homie. I gave every nigga.
You gave it 1,000. What was your, why give it 1,000? Why give us the set your life? Like,
you know why? Because you don't know. When you young, you don't even know, homie. All you know is that I want to be big homie, big homie. In order to be big homie, big homie, nigga, you gotta do that extraordinary shit in order to get to that level, to get that name, to get that status, right? And I watched this shit, man, when I went to prison, homie. And, man, I'm rapping, homie. Every nigga that know me know one thing, homie. You can call on Dude any day. That nigga coming. I'm coming, homie. If I fuck with you, and that's a major downfall, it's called keeping it too real. You see what I'm saying? I did 18 years, homie, for keeping it too real, my nigga. You my nigga, I don't give a fuck in the hallway. I don't give a damn where it's at. I'ma ride for you, my nigga. Because I feel like that's the way it was supposed to go. But when I start looking at this shit, I say, my nigga, we ain't doing nothing but guard against each other. Nigga, this black on black shit. Nigga, I got a squabble with another nigga. I'm watching, nigga, we going at each other more than anything. And then I'm tripped out because all these niggas that's supposed to be OG that was in the world that was shooting at each other, them niggas in the penitentiary eating spreads with each other. Why these niggas still got the war going on in the street? So we come back home to the streets. The war that's going on out here started because of them niggas that's in the penitentiary that's eating junnies and that's eating spread together, homie. That's showing each other love. But out here, these niggas, instead of killing each other behind the shit that y'all done started, my nigga. So why y'all niggas can't tell these young niggas the truth? Tell these young niggas the truth, homie. And that's the problem. Ain't nobody telling the truth no more, my nigga. And I came to tell the truth, nigga. Nigga, I ain't never fumbled a rock. My name is super solid. My shit's signed, sealed, and delivered, nigga. I ain't no rapper. I ain't none of that shit, nigga. I'm a real game, nigga, homie. You know what I'm saying? So my thing is, when we speak about the up and coming generation, they not listening to the old niggas no more, but they want to be the old nigga. They ain't listening to the old nigga no more, but they want to be the old nigga. Nigga, you heard my name. Nigga, you know my name ring bells. Nigga, you trying to impress me, but I'm one of them niggas say, homeboy, listen, little homie, you can't impress me. Nigga, you really a dummy out here, nigga. See, there ain't no more real niggas that's really stumped down that's giving these young niggas the real game no more. No, nigga, I'm not impressed because you got a motherfucking stick on you, nigga. No, do me a favor. I told a young nigga this here in North Carolina, and his partner just got smoked, and he was kind of going through it. And I said, say, my nigga, I ain't here to preach to you. I'm here to give you the game. I said, say, my nigga, if you feel like you still want to be in the streets and do what you got to do, and you know your mama hurt, nigga, do me one favor, nigga. Tell your mama to get your life insurance together, and you need to start paying your life insurance through your mama, because, nigga, you gonna die or go to the pen. It ain't no in between. Square business, my nigga. And the nigga be like, why you give that young nigga that game? Why play with him? Why play with him? Nigga think it's, man, nigga, I went to the penitentiary when I was 15 for murder. Come on, my nigga. I know what young niggas will do to you. So let's keep it real with these young niggas. When we see how far they done gone, say, man, you going to the penitentiary. Or, man, you going to be a hump on the ground. Why play with them?
Why play? Yeah, and it's crazy, right? Because we all got kids in here, right? And I got a 15-year-old, right? And I just be thinking, like, some of these kids that start slanging on, they be 12, 13. And I just be like, how do you get to the point where you're a 12-year-old slanging iron? Like, what is it? Is it, what would you say, you know, that is causing these kids to get so young to be in these positions to where they killing, shooting, selling dope this young?
Look at their mama. Look at their daddy. And then you look at the community. And then you'll be able to see what's going on. If mama wearing tight clothes, going to the club, shaking their ass, bringing a different nigga home that's a street nigga, that's selling dope, that's pants pulled down, coming inside the household. This is what this nigga seen. If mama love this nigga, guess what? That's the nigga I want to be. We got to be real about this shit, homie. So now what we dealing with? We dealing with a lot of babies that's watching mama. Then we'll come back. We watching when he walked down here, right? The same nigga that's driving the fancy cars, the G around, you know, the street nigga with the shit. Guess what they got with him? They got the BBL, bitch. They got, I'm just keeping this shit gangster, that's man. They got the BBL, bitch, man.
Yeah.
And get what they doing. Damn, ooh, man, I want that. This what the young niggas thinking, because you know why? The young nigga ain't going downtown. He ain't going to Frisco. He ain't going to Plano. He ain't walking down there seeing them bad motherfucking honeys with them niggas that got them goddamn me, them real jobs, man. Them doctors and lawyers. He ain't seeing that. Guess what he's seeing? He's seeing this ghetto shit, homie. And he thinking this shit live. He thinking the only way you can get a BBL bitch is by being a street nigga, homie. Let's keep this shit gangster, man.
That shit crazy.
Square business, keep it gangster, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. That's what's fucking it up, homie.
Right.
Look at all the videos. Look at all these niggas in the video, these street niggas with their sticks on it. What they got beside them?
BBL bitch.
A BBL bitch, man.
God damn.
I mean, I ain't saying nothing that ain't nobody seeing,
nah,
man.
Nah, that's facts, though.
Come on, homie.
That's facts.
So I'm trying to tell the young niggas, don't be impressed with the BBL bitch, man. It's a lot come with it. It's a lot come with it. Man, it's a lot of lawyers, doctors, goddamn me out here, man, say, man, they real bad, man. You just don't get a chance to see them because guess what? You secluded to the hood. You secluded to the hood, nigga. Them hood niggas, you see them 2 years, you trying to figure out where that nigga at, where he in jail. Then you getting word from these niggas, they ain't tell you the truth. What's wrong with it? They down there fucking with them boys. Why we ain't hearing the real stories about these penitentiary niggas, man? Why we ain't hearing the real stories about these gangsters that's going to the penitentiary and they don't even want to go to solitary? Them niggas snitching because they don't want to go to solitary. Oh, I forgot. Oh, they don't talk about that shit, huh? Oh, yeah. Nah, homie. Nah, man. So guess what, homie? It's a lot that come with this shit that ain't nobody talking about. Nigga, I'm here, nigga. I'm the voice of the motherfucking real now, man. All right,
let's do it like this then, man. We're gonna go through some penitentiary stories, man, because, again, like you said, niggas ain't talking about it. Niggas ain't talking about it. And you just mentioned it. Have you seen a nigga? What's the, like, were you seeing a nigga, like, who you knew was OG? You knew this nigga was gangster. You knew this nigga was shit. But a nigga might have his manhood tested. A nigga might got him molested by somebody. Like, did you know a nigga that came in that was on that shit and then he got turned around the other way?
Man, I don't even want to expose these niggas.
Oh, goddamn.
Say, man, listen, I'm going to give you some real game, homie. Man, don't be impressed with these nigga vocabulary words, man. Man, and I can talk that shit because guess what? Any nigga that ever done time with me gonna see this interview and get what them nigga gonna say. Every unit I've been on, nigga, I've been the shit. Mm. I've been the shit, point blank period. Mm. You hear me? So the shit I talk about, nah, man, they gonna say, nah, what? Nah, man, that's another type of nigga, homie.
Fact.
You feel me?
Facts.
But say, man, I see niggas out here right now. I see niggas out here right now. And they'll knock you out behind that Mexican booty.
Mexican booty.
They'll knock your motherfucking ass out behind that Mexican booty.
God damn.
Man, them niggas will go to, say, man, these niggas out here right now, they'll go to war with you behind that Mexican booty.
God damn. Well, shit.
What?
Well, shit. Damn. Enough said.
Man, they don't be talking the truth no more. Yeah, I'm exposed that shit. They better not say nothing. They better not say nothing. They know. Goddamn right. Be quiet, goddamn. Shit.
So, dude, let me ask you, man, what's the craziest fight you witnessed, man? Like, you personally witnessed that went down in the penitentiary.
Man, I seen so many goddamn fights. It don't make no sense.
The
wildest shit I seen on the inside is, man, I'm going to tell you something. Man, I seen fights, stabbing. That shit was, like, I was on Ferguson in the 90s, my nigga. That bitch was rocking and rolling. That bitch called Gladiator.
Damn.
That's the 90s, nigga. Damn. Gladiator. Nigga, if you get your head busted, nigga, all they going to do is see you to the infirmary. When you go to the infirmary, they going to say, welcome to Ferguson Unit. And bandage your ass up, and you going back out there to them goddamn woods, man.
Nigga put a nigga to sleep. What happens when a nigga sleep? Like,
it's all types of shit. It depends on who put you to sleep.
Damn.
Man, you got a nigga that'll put you to sleep and do some wild thing, and it's real life.
Damn.
And you know what's crazy about it, homie? This lets you know that you not, man, this shit ain't me.
Yeah.
Man, listen, nigga, I had to go to prison realizing that, man, this shit ain't me, my nigga. I was supposed to see this shit. Don't nobody supposed to see this kind of shit, man. All I know is this here. Man, mama, I'm going to make it home. I might not make it home in the time I supposed to, but I'm going to make it home. If I got to kill me, these niggas, I won't give a goddamn. Nigga, your baby going to make it home. A real nigga. I don't want no booty. I don't want none of that, nigga. I'm gonna make it home a real nigga, homie. And I stand on that, my nigga. Say, nigga, I remember time, nigga. Nigga, we got a stuck out shower. Nigga, I come in the shower. In the back, you don't want to go back there. You hear me? Nigga, I come in the shower, nigga. I'm thinking ain't nobody in the bitch. Nigga, I go to the back of that bitch, my nigga. Man, this the wildest shit I ever seen in my motherfucking life. And this let me know right then and there, man, God, man, I want to go home. And it wasn't about no nigga getting stabbed. Say, man, a bitch, say, man, this nigga was a Mexican. Had a nigga dick in her ass, a nigga dick in her mouth, a dick in her right hand, a dick in the left hand, and had some nigga jacking off. Nigga, I knew right then and there, I said, man, I got to go home, man. I got to go home, man. Man, I'm saying, man, I told my mama, nigga, I went to visitation that week. I went to visitation, I told my mama. I say, mama, man, I got to come home. This shit is crazy. Man, come on, homie.
So how did you personally survive that 18 years? Like, how did you, had to just turn into a different type of nigga? Like,
man, you got to turn into a monster, nigga. I turned into a monster.
Yeah.
Man, I turned into a monster, my nigga. Nigga, I'm a squabber. Nigga, what? Let's get the, nigga, I'm going, yes. Niggas playing ball, hoe ass nigga. Okay, then, let's go. You got to set the standard.
So a nigga fresh into the penitentiary, it's best that he fight a nigga.
Man,
to let a nigga know.
I tell every nigga that come to the penitentiary, because one thing about me, homie, I went into the bully shit, but I was into making a statement.
Yeah.
I ain't like that bully shit, but I can't get involved. I can't stop it. I'm being real. I can't stop it.
Yeah.
Because you can't, nigga, if you a hoe, you a hoe.
right.
I might feel bad when I be seeing it happen, but goddamn.
I'm exposing, goddamn.
I got to stay, you know, that's how the game go. Mm. But I used to tell them niggas on the cool. When them niggas, you know, I know they finna squabble, you know, them niggas finna break you. I go by them niggas and tell them on the cool. My nigga, listen, this what you do. Whoever you squabble with, do one thing. Close your eyes and just swing straight. Don't worry about trying to win. Don't worry about trying to weed. Nigga, close your eyes and do this here. Wherever you go, just do this.
Yeah.
Cause you try to do it. Them niggas know too much. Them niggas know too much. All of those, that street shit. Yeah. Man, them niggas gonna hit you from your feet, the back of your motherfucking head.
Damn.
Nigga, them niggas go, they know too much.
Ain't no fighting fair.
These niggas know too much, homie. So I tell niggas, just swing straight. Just don't never stop. Just realize your life is on the line.
Yeah.
That's all I tell you. Fight your life is on the line, nigga.
Yeah. Literally.
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 Point blank, period. Nobody can save you. Nigga, that's my homeboy from the world. So we better not say nothing.
Yeah.
Nigga.
Yeah.
No, real talk, homie.
So I got to ask you, how much would you say from what you saw, how much corruption goes on with the prison guards, them niggas just putting their will on, doing what they want to do, drugs, scams, getting money out of niggas. How much goes on what you saw with the guards and the corruption?
Man, the prison is 100% corrupted.
Damn, not a hundred.
Homie. Prison is 100% corrupted.
Damn. So even a new nigga coming in is gonna get put, a new nigga coming in as a guard is gonna put on game on how to run game, how to run plays at this motherfucker.
A new nigga coming in is being taught to hate you. That's their job. Hate that nigga. You got laws that's against a nigga 1,000%. You got other laws, they kind of fuck with a nigga some, you know what I'm saying? But this is what's fucked up about it. These laws might fuck with you, but might fuck over him.
Damn.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Me and you, we here.
We got some.
But you a fuck over this nigga here, which is my partner.
Damn.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, damn.
So it's so much corruption going on the inside. And don't get it twisted, homie. You hear about all the stories with niggas, squabbling and doing what they doing. Nah, them laws were busting them niggas' head open. Man, laws were giving them niggas migraine headaches, man. Them laws, man. Them niggas ran from them laws, homie.
Like a lawman would have a personal vendetta against a nigga, like, nigga, I'm on your ass.
And they'll catch you going to trial. Get you on that wall and they'll fuck you up, homie.
Damn.
And I seen niggas, this come back to this gang shit, right? I seen niggas watch their partners get beat to death. And them niggas just went about their business, homie.
Damn.
I seen niggas scream this gangster shit, homie. But when it was time to get gangster with them laws, them niggas ran, homie. Nah, them niggas ran, homie.
Damn.
Now, I done seen where, nigga, we done, you know, we had to get out there with them laws. You know what I'm saying? But it in 90% of the time, homie, that shit don't be my people, though.
So you seen the niggas, like, go at it with the law? With the...
Yeah, nigga, we done. Stays the squabble on the yard. When the laws come out, nigga just go to whooping them hoes.
Damn, that sound like a riot about the shit.
You see what I'm saying?
Shit.
But I used to tell my homies this here, homie. Say, man, y'all gonna ride, but this ain't for y'all, my nigga. This for the color right now. Because that nigga was another set, and that nigga on set ran, homie. So now we got blacks that's putting their life on the line, homie. We got blacks putting their life on the line. So that's why I be saying, man, miss me with that gang shit. Miss me with all them old, man, miss me with
now,
that
so
shit, man.
I do have to ask you, even as you got out, how strong was gang mentality in prison? Would you say like once a nigga get in, let's say a nigga is not affiliated with no gang on the outside. Once he gets in, is he gonna have to really associate with a gang just to move forward in prison?
I'm gonna say this, man. A lot of them, they doing that. This one thing I realized by being in prison, what I saw. You got the gang niggas. You got the Muslim niggas. You got Christians. That shit segregated like that, homie. When I was locked up, homie, I'm gonna be honest with you. I was one of them niggas, because I was banging. I used to have some against Muslims. Nigga be like, man, I used to have some against Muslims because damn, everybody drop out the goddamn game, become a Muslim.
Yeah. What?
Everybody jump out the goddamn, everybody that say they don't want to ride no more become Assalamu alaikum. And I'm sitting there looking at this shit like, what the fuck is this? So, nigga, I done got into it with the head motherfucker over the Islamic community down there. Nigga, y'all ain't nothing but a gang. Nigga, don't talk to me about Islam, nigga. Fuck wrong with you? Come on, nigga, everybody down with y'all. They ex-gang members, quote unquote, until they become free again. Let's keep this shit real, my nigga. Come on, homie. I walked the yard, homie. I walked from the beginning to the end representing this gang shit. Came home and saying, nigga, fuck this gang shit.
Now, wait.
But them niggas that became Muslim, get what they did. They came home and get what they did. Man, them niggas ganging like a motherfucker.
Gang, gang.
Oh, them niggas hit you up rolling and everything. Come on, my nigga. This shit is
so, wait. So, do niggas go to the Muslim community for protection? Like, wait, and my question is this.
You goddamn right.
Does the Muslim community protect niggas, though?
Like, nigga, the Crips had a ride with the Muslims on Ferguson Unit, man.
Damn. Okay.
Behind a Crip, nigga. Come on, homie. This shit is... Man, say, homie, listen. That's why I say what I say, my nigga, and I stand on what I stand on. Because, my nigga, I stay solid, my nigga. Man, I ain't want to be nothing. Man, nigga, I supposed to been something to make it home to my mama. But, nigga, I ain't want to be nothing. I ain't want to be nothing, nigga. I wanted to be Crip. Even though, but them nigga bullshit niggas. That's, yeah, man. I got some bullshit ass niggas. Yeah, you goddamn right. And I knew that I would have to protect a lot of these niggas. I know that. Come on, homie. But, nigga, I made it home, my nigga.
Yeah.
Only to shine a light on the truth, my nigga. I'm just shining the light on the truth, man. That's point blank, period. And ain't nobody want to speak the real about this shit no more, my nigga. That what really get to me, homie. Let's talk real talk, homie. Let's talk real talk, man. That's point blank, period. I'm going to give y'all some game, man. A lot of people come up to me, right? And they say, man, why you with that nigga Charleston? Get what I tell them? One, don't never ask no why he with another nigga, no way. All right? Two, your big homie, he a real live hoe. Because he got money, you rocking with him. Nigga, this real life shit, nigga. In real life, fuck the internet. In real life, you know what your partner did down there. You know what your partner did out here. You overlook it because when he came home, guess what? He was back moving bricks. And guess what? Guess what these niggas say? Man, that nigga just snitch on me. Come on, homie, let's keep it gangster. That's why I tell a nigga, shut up and find out what's really going on. Man, homie, I'm just giving you some real game.
So from your perspective, right, like you said, like you'll see like Charleston White go at Jay Prince, right? The Jay Prince family, right?
Yeah.
And you know, from the outside looking in to a lot of people, that's a thing where you just don't go against Jay Prince, right? It's Texas. He's so close to Houston, that type of thing. Do you ever feel like certain things shouldn't get to a certain level? Because he was every day making a video about stuff like that.
You know what? This real life, homie. I'm from Dallas. From Dallas, Texas. All right?
Yep.
Ain't no one motherfucker can run this bitch. We went through the Jamaicans era.
Yeah.
Nigga, we done went through all eras in Dallas, Texas. from the South. Nigga, come on, homie. The Ray Charles era.
Yeah.
The Curtis Blow era. One Arm George and West Dallas era.
Yeah.
Come on, homie.
One Arm George, not free.
Listen, homie, we had respect for each other boundaries. One thing about all these people I just named, and it's plenty more, is this here. We didn't never get these cameras.
Yeah. Yeah.
The industry did never come into our neighborhood and speak about this, homie. The only thing that happened in Houston, Texas was, it's called the industry. Once that industry shined a light on Jay Prince, when they shined a light on Jay Prince, homie, they made him bigger than life. These cameras in the industry can make anybody bigger than life. Because you know why? Everybody want to be in the industry. Mm-hmm. If everybody want to be in the industry, and if you got the light to put people in the industry, guess what they going to do? People going to come around just to do what? Be in the industry. If you's a chess player, you know how to play chess. Go over here with these young niggas and tell them niggas they down with the label. You know what they's doing? Making them feel like they got a position. That's how you get niggas on your team. Because that light a bad motherfucker. It did it to Death Row. It did it to every fucking label, my nigga. Let's keep it gangster, homie. Yeah. But guess what? Them real steppers, they don't talk about One Arm George. A real boss owned the whole, I'm talking about put it down for a whole street. Talk about houses on both sides. Real boss. Nobody talks about that. Half of people don't know nothing about that because you know why? The cameras.
Right.
The industry. Come on, man. I got Curtis Blow. Ray Charles done finally made it home. Nobody talks about these stories because in Dallas, we don't really talk. This just starting to happen.
Right.
Let's keep it real. Everybody else got cameras in their face.
So can you take us through the day that, because I think, was it a kids event? Was it that they got canceled? What happened?
Man, listen, homie. That shit was just an event for Charles to go down there and speak to the kids. You know, the kids rocking with him and whatever. But when you got so much going on from the Takeoff, Duke the Jewel, you got all that shit done went on down there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now you probably got the officers out there, all them probably trying to figure out like, God damn, we already trying to solve these situations. We trying to get this, we trying to get that. Hey man, Miss Powell, do you feel like that we can holler at Charleston and you know, I ain't canceling my event.
Yeah, I'm like.
You know what I'm saying? But what happened was Charleston shined a light on the event that nobody cared about. Nobody ever spoke about. So what he did was he got the whole world talking about that event all in the name of Rap-A-Lot and Jay Prince.
Damn.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Shine a light on the real shit because y'all want to follow the fake shit.
Yeah.
Because I tell a nigga this here, homie. If we got so much power, We should have more millionaires.
Facts.
We should have more millionaires, homie.
Facts.
Right?
Facts.
If you got so much power, let's sit down and talk about some big dog shit. I go to Fuel City, nigga, and I ain't never seen one black work at Fuel City since I've been here.
Nah, for real.
Do I knock that? No.
At all.
But guess what? I tell everybody, y'all need to watch what they doing. They building. Mm. We playing gangster. I'm tougher than you. Nah, I'm tougher than you. Nah, nigga, when I see you, I'm going to knock you down. Okay, what I'm going to do, let you knock me down? Nah, nigga, we going to knock each other down. And then guess what? We all lose.
Yeah.
So when we going to start talking real shit?
Nah, for
or do we want to still talk, I'm tougher than you shit? Mm. When we going to start building as blacks? When we going to start building, homie? Nah, we ain't doing no building, my nigga. Everybody trying to outshine each other. Every time you see these young niggas get $1 million record deal, they go get this jury that's financed.
Yeah.
They go, they automatically go to beefing with another nigga, homie. My nigga, I think we the only culture that got millionaires that beef with each other.
Yeah, yeah, I'm talking about not trying to build, not trying to build shit.
Homie, we the only culture that got real life millionaires that sit around and beef with each other. Them niggas ain't doing no building with each other.
God damn. Message.
We the, homie, 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 listen, homie. Real life. We the only motherfuckers got millionaires. We sit around, homie, and watch these niggas destroy each other over nothing. Over nothing. Nah, nigga, my dick bigger than yours. Nah, nigga, my brand new shoes cost more than yours. Nah, nigga, I got on the motherfucking necklace. That bitch cost $5. Nigga, these niggas arguing about who necklace the biggest. These niggas talking about who watch the prettiest. Nigga, we fucked up, homie. Let's keep this shit a gangster, man.
Okay.
Why?
And because I was thinking about this too. Like, we put like strippers on a pedestal as a rap, like as a community, right? Like niggas is chasing strippers, like you say. There's actually doctors and lawyers and women that that aren't like that, but we all chase that. It's like the mentality of the black people. Like, how do you think we can change some of this narrative, bro?
Man, I'm gonna be honest with you, homie. I don't got no problem with them strippers. Man, listen, homie, because for one, is that the seduction of the mind is a motherfucker.
Yeah.
But the only thing about it is that how females don't know how to seduce without giving in. You can make money a doctor and a lawyer, mate, just dancing now. But the problem is when they don't know what to do with the money. So I feel like that instead of knocking the strippers, let's put these motherfucking strippers in finance classes. And let's get them the game on how much money you make a night. How much you do this? Okay, where you trying to get at in life? Where you trying to be at? Do you think somebody's sitting around giving them that kind of game? Yeah. Come on, homie. Let's keep it real. So they don't know. 90% of strippers, they see street niggas. Nigga, have you noticed that every time it's a dope shortage, the strip clubs is empty?
Yeah, nah, facts.
Every time it's a dope shortage, the strip clubs is empty.
Nigga, where they at? Where they at, though?
So why we not giving game to the strippers on, hey, man, listen, ain't nothing wrong with dancing, baby. But always remember, this shit got to come to an end. Your knees going to get weak. You going to get old. Nigga, that ass is gonna get lumpy.
Big
then lumps. Another thing, nigga, everybody talking about you. Lil Joe had you, Pablo had you, Lil Peter, nigga sitting in the trap. Nigga, you come through the door, this nigga think he got a star. Nigga, you come through the door, everybody like, oh man, that nigga fucking with that hoe. Oh man, that nigga too. Yeah. Come on, my nigga, you know how this shit go.
Nah, for real.
That's some real
shit. Cause I, you ever been with a girl where, like you say, you just walk in and everybody the fuck with her? You like, oh,
everybody just stop. That's how you know what's going on. Tell you, man, they say sometime when you get a chick, man, take them around the homies. Let the homies be doing something and just walk through the door with your chick and you just look at all them niggas.
Yeah.
If them niggas start doing this.
Yeah.
Oh, man,
God,
bitch,
I gotta go talk to this nigga on the side.
Man, this nigga had my bitch, man. I thought I had a star.
Damn. Nah, it was crazy. Hey, these females, they'll make $6,000 in one night, like you said, and don't have a car, don't know what to do with it. Nigga, just like, nigga, I'm gonna go blow it. I don't know how to, nigga, I don't know what, nigga, let me get rid of this money. But
in all these hoes, you just say it like that. Instead of going to get a regular apartment in their name, building up their credit, these hoes doing CPNs. These CPN ass hoes killing me, man. God damn.
Never like it's no tomorrow.
Woo! Man, say, man. Listen, man, these hoes CPN motherfuckers ain't using for nothing professional.
For real.
Nigga, CPNs are for professional individuals who got, that's what it's for.
Yeah.
Man, say, man. Man, we got a problem.
We got a problem.
And we need to fix that problem, man.
Now we got to.
We need to fix the problem. That's why I'm saying, here come out, and here it come again. How can you be so motherfucking me, gangster and running shit, but ain't nobody getting no game from you?
Facts.
Hey, you know what's funny? Like, I almost look at you like Wallo from $1 Million Worth of Game. Like, you kind of got that motivational aspect to you. Like, you ever thought about like just being a motivational speaker? Like, let me send my fucked up kid to Newberry so he getting his ass real quick.
Send that nigga over here. I'm gonna give him some good game.
Nah, nigga, some very good game, nigga.
You goddamn right. And I feel like that, nigga, that's what the world is missing. The world is missing the truth, homie. You know that's what I'm facts. Saying? Now, I'm gonna give you some more game, right? And this might not be on y'all questioner, but I'm gonna bring it up. Wallo, then, since you brought up Wallo, right?
Yeah.
They done went down here to boycott because they want Pooh Shiesty out, right?
Oh, damn. Okay, yeah.
And everybody saying, nigga, that's some real nigga shit right there, my nigga. Right?
Yeah, that's what they on.
Are we saying that's some real nigga shit because it's Pooh Shiesty?
I think so.
Huh?
I think so.
Okay, then.
I think so.
What about the rest of the niggas that's doing the bid, homie, that should have came home and them niggas ain't done nothing?
Right.
So we just saying fuck them niggas. We only saying, and this nigga Pooh Shiesty is still right home talking about what he gonna do, how he gonna slide, and how he gonna do this. Nigga, you ain't learned a motherfucking thing in the penitentiary, nigga. The number one thing you should have learned by doing time in this year, nigga, close your motherfucking mouth, nigga.
Damn.
If you don't learn nothing else, you should learn the finesse game to be quiet until you're free, nigga. And once you become free, nigga, you can crash out. But goddamn, be quiet, nigga. You still locked up.
Homie. As a black man, how many people do you feel was innocent sitting in the penitentiary? Like, really did not do the crimes that they got convicted for?
Man, I'm going to be honest with you, homie. I can't really say, because a lot of these niggas lie like a motherfucker.
to the death.
Man, I know some niggas that committed crimes. And them niggas in a law bear every day getting they crime cases overturned because it's one little error in there. And them niggas using that to get out. And they said, nigga, I told y'all I ain't do it. Man, shut your stupid ass up. Nigga, you just got through the game. Nigga, we know the game. I'm just keeping it real. But I had one partner, man, that he was my next door neighbor, man. Old nigga, homie. He was locked up, man. At that time, he was locked up like 20-something years. Mm. And the nigga used to always tell me, if I go to parole and say that I did what I did, they'll let me go because I got to show remorse. And it was a sexual assault case. And I told him straight up, I said, why you just don't play the game? Get your ass out of here.
Right.
He said, I can't, man, because I ain't do it.
Damn.
And he used to tell me that shit, man. And my nigga had counsel. You know, he was my next door neighbor, man. I looked out for him. I'm talking, that was my nigga, man.
Damn.
And I remember one day, he said, say, man, Craig Watkins, them doing something. Whoop, whoop, whoop. I'm finna go back to court. They finna do the. And I'm like, for real? Like, I said, all right, that's a bet. You know, everybody in the penitentiary talk. But that nigga left. And I remember, I was in the day room and I was looking at the TV And I seen that nigga come through the court. And they freed that nigga. DNA came back. I said, God damn, that nigga free.
Damn.
And that shit fucked me up, right?
Yeah.
When I got out, right, I seen the nigga, homie. You know, he got his money and shit, you know what I'm saying? He got in my house, he living life, doing what he was doing and shit, man. But that nigga, he died of cancer, homie.
Yeah.
He died of cancer, homie.
Damn.
And that shit was crazy, man. Because I feel like it's a 1% in there. It's a 1%, homie, that might didn't do it. It's like a 1%, homie. Now,
so you wanted him to take that? You wanted him to?
I wanted,
bro, won't you just tell him you did it to show remorse and get out? You want him to, and he knew he didn't do it.
Yeah.
So you was like, man, just tell him you did it.
Yeah. Damn. I seen my nigga go through so much, homie.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? And I was wrong for telling him that, but.
That's the game.
That nigga goddamn me came home, homie.
That's the game.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, what I say, it's a 1%, man. You know what I'm saying? And I say this here, man, that, man, the one that done went down there, homie, they supposed to be back home setting some real examples.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I don't glorify prison, homie. I barely talk about prison, homie, because I don't glorify. People might think you glorified it, but then it's to the point now where you got to start speaking about it just to get the awareness about it, like what this shit really about down there, homie.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
And it's just like that now. It ain't shit cool about being locked up. Ain't a motherfucking thing.
At all.
If a nigga think it's something, man, I feel like all female can stop niggas from going to the penitentiary.
For real.
Facts.
For real. That nigga.
Say, man, do you know how many females that can tell a nigga, I don't talk to niggas that say it. Do you know how many niggas start pulling up their pants?
Yeah.
Do you know how many niggas start pulling up their pants on me?
Not for real.
If a female don't give you no pussy, cause nigga, these niggas, homie, these niggas is fucked up behind that pussy, man. I'm just giving you some real game, homie.
Understatement of the world.
You know what I'm saying? So, once we start back building up the queens, man, them kings gonna get right, homie.
Nah, for real.
Trust me, homie.
Nah, for real.
Now it's gonna take some kings to step out of that. We gotta step out. We need some real nigga to step up.
Got to.
It's gonna be hard, the motherfucker. And I ain't gonna lie to you. I hate talking to these niggas, man. I like to talk to them kids every day. Say, man, listen, y'all. This is what we gotta do, homie. Like I told y'all before, man, today, real life street stars, I'm calling all my bloggers out.
Let's go.
I'm calling all my bloggers out. Do me a favor.
Let's go.
Say, man, when I'm going to start seeing y'all at the banquets? When I'm going to start seeing y'all at the Little League football games, homie? When I'm going to start seeing y'all? Because one thing about it, man, y'all are major people in this game. And all these babies want is to be seen.
Yes.
And if a baby being seen on real life, nigga, you would change that baby life. They gonna talk about it at school. They gonna talk about it everywhere, my nigga.
That's the spark.
Don't let me go catch nobody to be on the show, man. No, man, don't let me go catch nobody. Why do I gotta catch a body to get on the show, man? Y'all know what I'm talking about, my nigga.
Yeah.
Come on, homie.
Yeah.
We hearing about these rappers we ain't never heard before in our lives. Soon as they get hit across their head, we hear about them. Come on, my nigga. Why, come on, man.
Come on. Hey, you saying some real shit?
Talk to us about that. I mean, one thing that nobody can discount is the work that y'all put in the community, man. Tell us about some of the events that either y'all got coming up or that you just did that people need to know about.
Man, we just did a banquet, man. In West Dallas, man. You know what I'm saying? For the West Dallas Vikings, for all the kids, man. Man, they came together, man. They gave kids trophies, man. I'm talking about trophies was so big. Man, what I try to do is, because I'm on the road so much now, is that I like to shine a light on the real people in our community that's doing real work.
Yeah.
Like, nobody talks about Dedrick Tubbs, right? Dedrick Tubbs is somebody that he did time in prison. I knew him when he was a young nigga. I used to think he was gonna be I thought he was gonna be the nigga to make it to the NFL. He was a star before I left the world. But when I got locked up, I started hearing about robberies and shit. I'm like, what the fuck? But he ended up getting locked up. He did the bid, came home. But the day he came home, he been 1,000% in the community. He called me, say, dude, I'm finna do a cleanup. I bet, I'm coming. We gonna set it up. We'll just walk around and pick up trash in the hood.
That's
stop
real.
The violence. Let's clean up. Cause the message is, if your community is clean, it make you think better. If your community is just dirt and trash everywhere, how can you think?
Facts.
You see what I'm saying?
Facts.
So I watched him, homie, stay focused with the kids. Not just during football season. He do basketball. He just do dang just because, homie. But nobody shine the light on that. Mm-hmm. Nobody gives a fuck about that, homie. And he the one that's trying to shape the next generation.
Now, facts. Facts. I think it was Master P who just said, like, man, we will shine a light on beef, like me and my son beefing.
Oh, homie.
But I'm also doing so much for the kids and, you know, putting on that. No one shine a light on the positive I'm doing.
Nobody, homie.
And it's like, is it because the people don't have an attention span to gravitate towards the positive? We
it's
like
not
to see. We love to see a train wreck.
It's not entertaining.
Mm.
So I'm gonna go back to this, right? When we speak, right? We hear people, I hear a lot of people say, oh man, say that nigga Charles said some crazy shit on the internet.
That's how I start.
I'll be like, okay, what you want me to do? But why did he say that? Why did he say that? This is what I hear. I hear this shit so goddamn much, right? And I say this here, my nigga. I'm 45 years old. I have never seen one nigga take over internet like this. I never seen this shit.
Never
and he's
seen
my partner,
it.
So it's
seen.
Fucked up.
Never
so
seen.
I sit here and I say, you got one nigga on the internet telling y'all, when I'm in a community, nobody gave me a light. When I was in the community feeding these kids, nobody gave me a light. When I had no bow tie and I never cussed and I was walking around like this, nobody gave me a light. Nobody said my name. Nobody showed me love. And every time I look at Dedrick Tubbs, I say the same thing. Nobody's showing light. But get what Charleston did. He came on the internet where it is called entertainment on YouTube. Nobody, nigga, I think I'm the only motherfucking nigga on YouTube that talk positive.
Right.
Nigga, and guess what? Yeah, I got over down to 40,000 subscribers and all that shit. Yeah, I get hundreds and thousands of views on that. But I tell a nigga, I say, you think I could have had 100,000? Easy, all I could have did was say, Charles, who you went to it with? Man, fuck them hoe-ass niggas, man. Them bitch-ass niggas don't want to die. Guess what would have happened? My shit would have been at 1,000, 100
Boom.
Million.
Boom.
You hear me?
Boom.
But it's entertainment, though. It's entertainment. So why we don't act like this shit ain't nothing but entertainment, man? Why we in our feelings? Get out your motherfucking feelings, gangster.
Talk to him. Ooh.
No, homie. That's what I tell these niggas all the time when I hear these niggas. But say, nigga, don't tell me about a nigga saying, fuck Dallas. Nigga, last time I checked, nigga, when you go to court, they say Dallas against you.
Shit. Yo.
So you willing to throw your life away behind Dallas? Nah, nigga, I'd rather throw my life away behind my family.
So I gotta ask you then, it was Charleston that was on, and let me know if you was there, y'all was on the road, and a Black Lives Matter protester was all camera on, boom, ready to just, man, fuck, you ain't about the shit you on, just talking all that shit.
Mm-hmm.
You you on the road with Charleston and you see something like this happen, and I'm assuming y'all expect for shit like this to happen, because you know everyone has an opinion. But y'all eating y'all food, y'all in the look like an IHOP or something, and y'all having dinner, and then somebody comes up, phone zone. Is niggas doing this for clout? Do niggas chase clout when they see y'all?
Homie, we at a restaurant. We at a restaurant in Virginia, minding our goddamn business. Here come this nigga who want some clout. That's all you want is clout.
That's what it is.
You got your phones in your hand. Can I get an interview? My nigga, it's a fee. No, I said, when he said something about Black Lives Matter, so? And he went to talking all. Man, say, my nigga, did you get 5 minutes of fame, homie? And it's sad to say this. Why, how did one nigga got so many people want to get 5 seconds of fame? My nigga, do you know that motherfuckers sit around and say, oh, man, that nigga Dewberry gonna fall out with Charleston?
Oh, man.
Whoever fall out with Charleston gonna get 188 interviews tomorrow. I ain't never seen this shit, nigga. If you fall out with Charleston White and you have a problem, you get 588,000 interviews. I ain't never seen no shit like that in my life, my nigga.
God damn it. Now that's facts, bro.
I ain't never seen this shit. I just be sitting there watching this shit, saying to myself, man, what the hell the world came to?
Internet. Internet.
What the fuck?
Real.
And I'm just keeping it real, man.
Nah, it's real.
But guess what? These same people, I asked them, what are you doing to try to save the youth in our communities? What are you doing to save these babies that's out here with these sticks? What are you doing, homie? When the last time you spoke at schools, homie? I spoke at schools, man. I spoke at this school, man, in North Dallas. And I still remember, man, it's a kid, man. He don't have nothing, man. He ain't got no mama. He ain't got no daddy. He stayed with his auntie. And he was a big boy. And I remember, man, they brought him in there to talk to me. And I'm speaking with him, homie. And he broke down to me some real shit. He said, say, man. He said, I don't want to do none of this, man. He said, I don't want to steal a car. He said, man, I don't really want to do none of that, man. You know, I got some older guy be making me go steal cars and do all this shit, right? And I'm saying to myself, right, why are you doing it, homie? He said, because if I don't do it, then the people in my community ain't going to accept me, homie.
Yeah.
That shit hit me, my nigga.
Damn.
That shit hit me, man. Because I realized that we could say, nigga move out the community, but how can he move out the community? He's a baby. He don't have no money. His family don't even have money.
No resources.
He has nothing. The men have nothing. Man, Charles took the nigga to the mall and just bought him a bunch of clothes, homie. That nigga say, man, it's sad, homie. He had on, square business, homie.
Yeah.
We took him to the mall, man, and then pick out some shoes, homie. He didn't know what to pick out. Like, nigga had to literally tell him, bro, pick out whatever you want. Whatever you fantasize on wearing, man, just get them, bro.
That's real.
Come on, homie, just get them.
That's real.
I just want you to feel comfortable with knowing that, man, you done bought some brand new stuff. Now, I probably couldn't save that kid's life. I probably didn't say that. I probably didn't save his life. Because at the end of the day, guess what? He still got to go back to that community.
That's facts.
But how many of these niggas screaming everything else, but how many of these motherfuckers in that community trying to help? How many, homie? If we had all these niggas that's running their motherfucking mouth by being gangster, if we had all these millionaire niggas, these rap niggas that's running around with a bunch of niggas with entourages because they cowards, in a community trying to help out these babies and put them in a better position, my nigga, we can save this goddamn generation.
Oh, talk to him.
We can save this generation.
Talk to him. Now, I got to ask you, you've been on tour with Charleston. First of all, how has that been as far as just being on the road?
Lovely in the motherfucker.
God damn it.
Lovely, homie.
How was Memphis?
Ooh, that motherfucker was crazy.
Yeah.
Say, man, that motherfucker was crazy, man. Shout out to Memphis, man. I ain't going to lie to you, man. And we had a situation in Memphis, right, on the second show. Mm. It was a 400 max venue. We sold that bitch out twice.
Damn. Okay.
We sold that bitch out twice.
Okay.
On the second venue, after the show, a GD, a big old guy that was a GD, right? He walked up to me and he said, "Say, man, what's up, man?" He said, "What's up, dude?" I'm like, "Shit, what's up with?" He said, "Man, I'm a gangster disciple." I'm like, "Already." He said, "I watch all your videos, homie." He said, "I even turned my son on to your videos." He said, "I understand the message." And that shit kind of touched me a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Because so many people feel like that because you're a part of something that you can't really see the truth in this shit. Let's be real, homie. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got to do nothing, homie. You only do it because you want to be accepted. That's point blank period. We're not living in a world where if you don't do it, we're going to violate you and take you out. We're not living in that world, homie. Let's stop playing these games, bro. We're living in a world where everybody still want to be accepted. Got the older guys still want to be accepted as being triple OGs and shit. And you got a lot of these youngsters out here want to be accepted to where they really don't want to do this shit. But it just became a fad now. It's a fad now. What you want to be? You want to be a Crip? All you got to do is start saying you a Crip. What you want to do? You want to be a Blood? All you got to do is say you a Blood. Have y'all noticed that every fucking rapper, before they start rapping, they nothing. But soon as they start rapping, they gang. Come on, homie.
Yeah, it's crazy, bro.
Why in the fuck did they make 6ix9ine a member of the Bloods?
It's crazy.
Come on, homie. Let's be realistic about it. And I'm going to speak on this, right? On this 6ix9ine situation, because a lot of people speak about that. And I'm going to use that situation in a street term. 6ix9ine was considered a sheep. He was considered a sheep. You brought in a sheep that's going to make sure that we all are good. When you bring in a sheep to make sure we're all are good, our job is to protect the sheep. Right?
Right.
This is not a gang member.
Right.
This is a sheep that's going to produce so we all can live our best life. If we don't give him the right game, then he come out here screaming, whatever, right? I'm this, I'm that. You made him do that.
Right. They enabled him.
Right?
Yep.
He never put no work in. So you mean to tell me that you think that he should stay solid? And he never been battle tested? He's supposed to stay solid under street rules when he ain't never been up under them? In the store, listen to what I tell everybody. All the shit start coming out about how they kidnapped him, how they did all that, right?
Right.
And it seemed like that nigga still was gonna stay solid.
Yeah. At first.
Boy, when they said these nigga fuck your wife, nigga.
It was a wrap.
That nigga said, "I'm due."
All bets off.
That nigga said, "All bets off." Where we need to talk at?
Day one, nigga. Yeah.
Come on, homie. Yeah. And nigga say, man, but that nigga, nah, nigga. Let's talk about the disloyalty that happened before that. Oh, we gonna overlook that, right? Because they gangster? Or we gonna overlook the everything that happened? Remember I told y'all, if a nigga fucking on your bitch, my nigga, behind your back, that nigga ain't loyal to you. So, them rules off the table, right? That's what I be saying. These niggas ain't really talking this real shit no more. Miss me with that animated shit, homie. Let's start talking real shit, man. Nah, homie, that's all I'm saying, homie. And everybody, and I want to say this, all these motherfucking civilians, all these civilians, quit calling people snitches. Quit it. If you are a civilian, you live a law-abiding lifestyle, you don't supposed to call nobody a snitch, a rat, or nothing. You don't supposed to do that. Because if I slap the shit out you, you gonna call the laws.
You go, hey,
right or wrong, true or false?
Right or wrong, right?
If
right,
somebody
right.
pull up on you and hit you across your head, who you gonna call?
Nigga.
Come on, my nigga, let's keep this shit real.
Now, Dewberry, I gotta say, a civilian watching, let's say something like a YSL Woody, talking to the laws for 3 hours, just giving it all up. As a civilian, it's like, damn it. Like, nigga, I'm a civilian, but still watching that, it kind of, as a civilian, it hurts. Like, nigga, shit, you talking
to me. It don't hurt me. That shit don't hurt me. You know why it don't hurt me?
Give up your brother and just go.
You know why it don't hurt me, homie?
Go ahead.
That's part of the streets.
Wait. A nigga who's your brother, who's providing family, feeding your family, you supposed to go in the jail house and just start giving it up? When them niggas ain't even asking questions about the shit, you just going to give up extra shit. Like, I'm going to give you some extra shit you ain't even know that's happening right now just to save myself.
Nigga, they just start putting it on TV. These niggas been doing that.
Damn.
Man, listen. Man, I don't even want to hurt my city, but Dallas, Texas got so many motherfucking niggas that went to the feds. And everybody know that these niggas are full-fledged motherfucking me telltales. And guess what? They got a lot of money. So guess what? All bets are off. Mm. Miss me with that gangster shit.
Goddamn.
So what do you feel about people like kind of bending the rules for certain people? What is your thoughts on that?
All I tell these niggas is, man, you know what, man? I'm so far from these goddamn streets, my nigga, that I thank God every day. But you know what? When these niggas be bending the rules, I just sit back and watch these niggas and smile. But when they come to me and ask me about it, they get their feelings hurt. Because I hurt these niggas' feelings. I hurt these niggas' feelings, homie. Oh, man, but see, he said this. He said this, but he did this. You let me know which one we need to focus on. One thing about being a rat, rats don't tell you that they rats, homie. One thing about being a snitch, you can never define a snitch until it's time to go through the trials and tribulations, the court and all that, right? See, niggas need to start breaking down the definition of what a rat is and a snitch and all this shit is, all right?
Break down for
it. See, one thing about these niggas, they just using words because it sound good. This shit don't, this it only sound good for the rap culture, the hip-hop culture. Yo, rat ass nigga snitch, it sound good on the music when you rapping and you saying certain shit, right? It sound good, right?
Yeah.
Homie, if I ain't, me and you, we ain't committing no crime together, so how can I snitch on you?
That's fair.
I can, my nigga, I don't even know you from a can of paint. Why would I want to do a crime with you and I don't have no knowledge of you?
That's facts.
Come on, homie. So I'm not going to give you the opportunity to snitch on me. I'm not going to give you the opportunity to snitch on me because you a businessman, homie. And your job is to protect your business, protect your family, and make sure everything right. I should never want to come to you no kind of way, homie. If you come to me and you say, yeah, man, I had to, hey, you did, hold on, stop. Nigga, I don't want to know about what you did. I don't want to know about what kind of work you put in. Don't you tell me nothing, nigga, because I don't want to be the nigga to sit there and say, damn, man, that nigga did tell me he killed that nigga, bro.
Yeah, damn.
I don't want to be that nigga. So let's keep it real with each other, homie. My nigga, don't talk to me about that.
Don't put it on me.
Don't talk to me about that, homie. Hey. I don't want to talk about your, no. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. It seemed like self-preservation is law. Like, nigga, at the end of the day, self-preservation is like, fuck you, nigga, I'm trying to go home. And that's kind of where life lands. Now, you see niggas that, and again, this is back in the old law. You will see a nigga so about his business, so about his partner, so about his people, that nigga will take a charge for a nigga.
They used to.
You think that shit is dead? Like, nigga, I'll take that.
It's over. Nigga, my girl just called and said, baby, you need to come home. Your daughter, she's starting to act bad. Nigga, your son, you know you didn't do it. But baby, I can't do it. Man, fuck them niggas. That hoe ass nigga was trying to holler at me anyway. Oh yeah, fuck these hoe ass nigga. And guess what? My nigga, we must forgot how these niggas, homie, it's some niggas that played the game like this out here.
Yeah.
You in the feds, your bitch is in the streets working. She fucking with dope niggas. Yeah. And guess what? She is out here working. She telling the feds, hey man, listen, that nigga got a spot on such and such, that nigga got this, that nigga got that. Once they start busting these spots and shit, these niggas starting to come home. Mm. We don't see that, dude. Oh, we forgot about that, huh?
We don't see that.
Oh, we forgot about that? Oh, the streets quit talking about that, right?
Nigga.
Come on, homie. Let's keep this shit gangster now. We want to keep it real. Like, everybody want to keep it real, right?
Yeah.
So let's keep it real, man. Now, that's what I want people to do. Keep it real, homie. I keep it real because I tell a nigga all the time, don't talk to me about no criminal activity, homie. I don't want to, because I'm no.
Nigga.
But when I hear people make statements like, because I travel with Charleston, right?
Yeah.
And I hear people make statements like, yeah, man, when I see you, you blah, blah, blah. My nigga, I give you niggas the game. Shut up and just move. Don't put yourself in a situation to get your dumb ass locked up. Mm. Be smart, nigga. Mm. When you street niggas start going on the internet talking about how much work you gonna put in on somebody.
That's wild.
Come on, homie.
That's wild.
Nah, homie, let's keep this shit real. Y'all, we praise these niggas though, right?
Back.
Y'all nigga love Lil Boosie. Y'all nigga praise Lil Boosie.
Wipe it down.
Y'all say Boosie is the realest nigga that ever walked on this earth. When did real niggas start getting on the camera and start talking about his partner? Get the fuck out of here,
yeah,
man.
That did.
No, homie, I'm going to say, homie, I don't give a damn, homie. You my partner, nigga.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up with it, homie? Say, man, I need to holler at you, my nigga. What's happening, man? Some shit going across, man. Say, man, we need to sit down and have lunch. Let's sit down and talk, homie. That's what real niggas do. Mm. Oh, we forgot that? Man, let me holler at you, my nigga. I'm not going on that. I'm not finna go on DJ Vlad and talk about my partner, nigga, in front of this goddamn white boy. And I ain't hollering my white boy. I ain't hollering my partner on the phone. What happened, man? Let's keep it real, man.
The internet.
I'm gonna call my partner, homie. Anybody that's watching this, if you get into it with your partners, call your partner and have a conversation with him.
Yeah, nah. For everybody. Yeah.
Call them. Hey, what's up, homie? What's happening?
I'm hearing right. This. I'm hearing that.
Yeah. Let's talk, nigga.
Yeah.
Now, if we can't talk, that's cool. Now, if we go to the internet, we really just capping now. We really just capping now, homie, for a check. Mm. We really capping now. Let's keep it real.
Yeah.
Come on, homie. Goddamn, let's keep it. Y'all want to be real now? Let's talk about this real nigga shit now, man. Let's go, man. Say, man. So y'all got a real one on. Yeah, real
so
one
I have
on
to ask
this
you,
guy.
I have to ask you. T.I., he had a paperwork party to ask Boosie to pull up to, you know, hey, man, like, listen, nigga, you should have called me. We see Charleston White pull up outside in Atlanta where T.I. is.
And I'm in a goddamn car.
You're in, I say, were you there right there?
I'm in the car.
So, hey, I heard y'all say, man, we got a show to do. We ain't got time to do with this fuckery. But What do you think would have transpired if Charleston White would have hopped out and walked into that paperwork party?
It would have been chaotic. You'd be a goddamn fool to walk inside a person's house. Now, don't be too goddamn tough. Yeah, it's a such thing as being too goddamn tough now. You hear me? Yeah, you don't, goddamn, don't do the band like that. But you know, we had a podcast that was close to that. And it's crazy how it went down, right? But so we see.
Was T.I.'s situation, was it like public, like as far as anybody pull up? Like, hey, y'all you just put it out there, like, this is what
anybody
I'm doing.
Anybody can pull up, you know what I'm saying? So that's how they were. But I look at that situation and say, like, with T.I. doing that, you know what I say to myself, huh? Why in the fuck is an old ass nigga want to go to a club and say, paperwork right here? Man, fuck you niggas, homie. Think what you want to think. Whatever you niggas want to think what you want to think, nigga. Because I don't fuck with you niggas no way. Come on, homie, what happened to that? Man, fuck you niggas. Nigga, me and my team, whoever I got, nigga, they ain't going nowhere. Nigga, I ain't got to prove nothing to now, motherfucker, nigga.
Now, would you say a nigga being labeled a snitch, would that fuck up his paper, though?
And where at, though?
In rap.
Say, homie, 6ix9ine selling our shows across the world. Homie, listen, the industry these niggas don't run the industry.
So you think Gunna's still gonna have a career?
Gunna gonna sign with a major label and they gonna push that nigga music and he gonna sell worldwide. Do you think that, homie, nigga, do you think, I'm gonna tell y'all something. Y'all know who the most, who support this music shit, who buy the music, go to shows more than anything? Females. These females don't give a damn about who's snitching. Get these motherfucking, man, they won't. Nigga, they looking at the fame. These niggas in the streets, they the minority. These street niggas is so goddamn me small. Nigga don't even want them to come in their club no more. Nigga sick of them. Come on, homie. Nobody gives a damn about these street niggas no more, my nigga. The industry makes you a star. He drop an album. They gonna put it on K104. They gonna put it all over these motherfuckers. Because guess what? They get a check for doing it. Do you get what I'm saying?
Nah, facts.
Come on, homie. Come on, homie. Let's be real about this shit. Let's stop playing gangster. And let's keep it real. Nigga, listen to what I just said. You got street niggas that went to the Fed, came home, these niggas got bricks.
Yeah.
And when they were down there, everybody was running across the hood to like, look, y'all, ooh, that nigga on his paperwork, look. Right? He came home, stocky, and guess what? They found out he got the bricks, y'all. Now, guess what? He got a whole team of niggas now. You think that these people really give a fuck? Alpo didn't get killed for snitching. He got killed for fucking a nigga bitch.
Yeah.
Come on, homie, let's keep this shit gangster. That nigga ain't dead for snitching, homie. He dead for fucking a nigga bitch. Come on, homie, let's stop playing this gangster shit, man.
So, I got a question. Do you ever have to like tell Charleston like, "Hey, nah, not this one, bro." Like,
man,
"Hey, go on, delete that one, bro. This one might be a little too far."
I ain't gonna even lie to you, homie. When my nigga go, he go. So I just sit there and let my nigga, he'll go. When it's over with me, he might have a conversation about it later on. And I just say, man, my nigga go.
Fuck. He said, my nigga.
Yeah.
10 toes down. Goddamn, we go.
That's my nigga.
Yeah, we go rock.
Because I look at it like this here, man. I understand a lot of that nigga message. I do. Without I really question. Do, homie. And a lot of people don't understand, nigga, I'm from the ghetto, homie. I'm going to give you some game about the ghetto. When you sitting under that tree, you got some niggas around there, old ass niggas. Oh, bitch ass nigga, you a hoe. You dick sucker. Nigga, fuck you. Nigga, no, nigga, fuck your mama, bitch ass nigga. I'm from the ghetto, homie. You know what I was told? Man, leave them goddamn people alone. If you say something to them goddamn niggas, they play hard. Man, you so I learned you got niggas like Top Dollar, Yard Man. Come on, you know not to play with them niggas, homie. They play too hard. Them niggas play, them niggas goddamn, you gonna be around a bunch of bitches and them niggas be like, suck my dick, baby boy. And you be like, come on, my nigga, goddamn, bro. You gonna be playing now? But them niggas play like that. So I tell myself, why fuck with Charleston when he gonna go there with you? And he, nigga, because what you trying to do is, ain't you trying to belittle him? Ain't you trying to ruin his career? Ain't you trying to say shit to make him look bad? Well, some people don't take that lightly. Some people, nigga, I'm from the ghetto. Some people talk about uncles, mamas, cousins, babies, everybody get to work. Mm. We forgot that? So we forgot streets, right? That's what I keep telling niggas, stop playing, man. I'm from the, I mean, I know, you see that nigga over there? Yeah, he don't talk, do it. No. Leave him alone. If you go fucking with that nigga, man, that nigga might run to your house and knock everybody down, babies and all.
Damn.
But guess what? Leave that man alone. Oof. Everybody's not living by your rules, man. Quit trying to make up rules, man. Y'all forgot Scarface?
That nigga, they must have forgot.
Y'all forgot Scarface when that, what's his name, Sosa said, hey, man, what happened? Man, it was babies in the car. I don't give a goddamn. And he sent the boy to get him. Scarface saying, no kids. Sosa saying, everybody. Watch who you play with sometime, homie. That's so, keeping the gangster, man.
So I got to ask you, Dewberry, you know, again, you could just say if it's cap or what your thoughts on it. Motherfucker come out saying, hey, Charleston White out in the parking lot. I mean his ass. Is that cap?
Go back to what I just said. I never in my life seen where you could say something about one person in the whole world or talk about it. I never seen that, homie. I never in my life seen where you can say something about one person. There's no evidence, there's no visuals, there's nothing, and everybody will talk about it.
God damn.
Charleston White done fucked the industry, my nigga.
God damn.
I never seen that, homie. Damn. For one person to come on her, and you know what? She did that because she said, damn, I can become famous. I'm gonna say this. My nigga, and then you got a footage. You can't see nothing. You can't see a motherfucking thing. Who take pictures of it? That's used common sense now. What happened to the video? That video is supposed to have been rolling. That bitch supposed to have been rolling. You know on that iPhone, you hit that bitch zoom all the way in? You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Come on, homie. But guess what? Man, that bitch got 5 minutes of fame just for saying, Charleston White. Man, I think, man, say, man, sometimes I think people need to sit back and realize, man, that nigga done fucked the YouTube. Boy, that nigga done, man, I ain't never seen this shit, man.
I don't think nobody has, bro.
Man, I'm talking about, I'm sitting there like everybody. Man, I seen niggas say, Charleston, you banned from such and such. Yeah. You know why? Charleston, please say something back to me. Because if you say something back to me, YouTube gonna take it and I'm gonna be able to get some goddamn likes and views. I ain't never seen no shit like this in my goddamn life, homie. Let's keep this shit. Goddamn.
Does this shit ever get to him? Does it ever make him be like, fuck this shit?
Man, you can't get, man, when you a master of a game, nigga, you gotta learn how to play. You gotta know how to play this shit, nigga.
Yeah.
You gotta know how to play this shit, nigga. That nigga took Rat Williams to the stage.
Yeah.
Nigga, everybody, oh, that nigga Rat, he took Rat Williams to the stage. And guess what? Nigga been talking about he had paperwork for how long? And ain't nobody showed it. But soon as this nigga, soon as Terrence Williams, they had paperwork on him, man, every goddamn blogger going from page to page. Right?
Right.
Come on, homie. Motherfuckers say anything because they want an interview. Man, motherfuckers will say anything. They want an interview. They want to be on one of these major platforms sitting right here like I'm on this pretty couch right here. Yeah, man. Say, man, listen, man. That whole ass nigga, they want to do this here, man. Say, man, like I told y'all, it's a lot of kids want to be on here too. See, get these niggas, these old ass niggas want to get on here and talk they shit. But they ain't doing nothing, homie. These niggas, okay, after all that, what y'all doing now?
So I got to ask you, Do Bears on the Couch, what we want to do, we do want to talk to your brother. He was able to come through last interview and sit down on his couch with you. Legend.
Legend.
Do you feel like even his stories?
Legend.
Oh, okay, okay.
Homie, let me tell y'all something, homie.
Okay.
I'm going to be honest with y'all. When you hear a story like Paid in Full.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They made a movie about it, right?
Facts.
Right? True or false?
Facts.
Say, homie, I can literally go in West Dallas and do the Gator Boy stories, and it's way bigger than that. Yeah. These niggas had alligators. These niggas got tigers, my nigga.
Damn. Alligators and tigers?
Come on, homie.
Shit.
Nah, this in the 2000. Look it up. Gator Boy. West Dallas Gator Boy.
Damn.
Nigga, they had houses all around the hood. Nigga, they had every young... Them niggas were getting real money, man.
Damn.
But guess what? These cameras. We don't have that. New York. Them niggas got cameras in their face 24/7. They talk about that. Ray Charles, that nigga had this, them nigga had the South, the Oak Cliff on lock.
Lock.
Real money.
Lock.
Homie, Curtis Blow, this nigga ride Rolls Royces way back in the 90s, homie. That nigga used to have on necklaces this goddamn big, man. Them niggas were getting real money, man. That nigga gave away all his money and got out the game cold turkey. These stories we don't talk about, you know why? Because, homie, the cameras, that's not what we do down here, homie. Why y'all don't hear a lot of prison stories down in Texas? You know why? Because niggas down here that's putting in work, them niggas, we don't talk, my nigga. When I start talking on the internet, man, I got people say, damn, dude, what's going on? What you doing, baby? We know we don't do all that. Nah, nigga, I'm finna change the game. Now, them same people say, man, I appreciate what you doing, my nigga. I appreciate what you're doing now.
Nah, for real.
So, well, don't forget or think that them niggas' stories is bigger than ours. And I say it again. That's like the BMF. My nigga BMF and them did their thing, right?
Yeah.
Man, say, homie, it's some stories, man. It's some stories that we can talk about in Dallas, Texas. Man, that'll goddamn me sell out. That'll go, man, listen, homie. But guess what?
What's that?
We ain't got the industry here, homie.
Right.
We don't got the industry. We can't walk down the street or go downtown and walk in the building to talk to Universal. We can't go down the street. We can't go talk to what made a lot of these niggas famous. Let's keep it real. What made a lot of these so-called street niggas famous? A fucking rapper.
Yep.
A fucking rapper, man. Let's keep it real. Man, Jay-Z was talking about that nigga such and such on his song. So we gotta realize we ain't really had nobody to make it down here, homie. Let's keep it real, man. We ain't really had nobody to make it, homie. And if they did make it, they never gave the culture of this bitch, homie. They never gave the culture of this bitch, my nigga. And I keep it real, because a lot of these niggas, they ain't never been nowhere. I ain't gonna lie to you, a lot of niggas, some of these niggas probably be in the cliff and ain't never been to the dock. Now when it came down to getting money or putting in work or doing something major or fucking with niggas on some, come on, homie, let's keep it real, man. Come on, homie, because you got major niggas don't even fuck with a lot of these young niggas, man.
Yeah.
Let's keep it real, right? Come on, homie. Nah, homie. And I got real, like I told y'all, it's a difference between OG niggas and legends. And the reason why I call my bro them and these nigga legends is because everywhere they went, they ran shit. They ran shit, nigga. From the penitentiary to the streets, them niggas ran shit. I swear to God. I swear to God. And a nigga told me some shit about my partner Cedric Rose. That nigga was a knockout artist. He in the feds. He still knocking niggas out, doing what he gonna give a fuck. But niggas say, wait, why you ain't talking about that nigga? He was goddamn fucking niggas. Where you wanna know about it? That nigga gonna knock you out and fuck you.
Man, that's a terrible combination.
Yeah, he was one of them niggas that'll knock you out and fuck you. So, hey, man, fuck it, it is what it is. Nigga wanna know, I know some nigga that'll knock you out I ain't gonna lie to you. Damn. Keeping it real, homie. But get one thing about when I say my bro name, my nigga, that nigga kept it solid, man. And guess what? Money make a lot of niggas relevant. That nigga name is relevant because he stays solid. A lot of these niggas relevant because they got some money. Right. It's not the same.
Well, can you tell me three stories that need to be told? You said the Gator Boy, the West Side Gator Boy.
Man, listen. Number one story got to be told. I feel like Ray Charles' story got to be told.
Come on, yeah, got to be told.
Ray Charles really, that nigga done some big dog shit.
Facts.
But he never came to the West. We never let nobody.
Y'all didn't let him come to the West?
Nobody.
Or?
Damn. Nobody. The Jamaicans, when they had this bitch on lock, they couldn't come to the West. They tried to open up a spot in the West, that bitch was shut down the next day.
God damn.
You're not coming down there. No, it's not happening. It's not happening. I feel like that guy, Ray Charles, he shaped it and molded this game a certain type of way. So I feel like that story got to be told. The Gator Boys, that story got to be told.
Facts.
And in the connection with that story, his story got to be told, connected to that, because George, the Tyrone and Monk, that was his son. That was, you know, he the daddy, you know.
Yeah.
So they got their game from their daddy. You know what I'm saying? And they watched their daddy. And so I feel like them stories need to be told.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it need to be told because right now, Patrick Weatherall, which was one of the leaders of the Gator Boys, he's still locked up in the feds.
Yeah.
And I feel like that he got too much time, homie. But I feel like these stories that can be told so the world can see and we can free my nigga, homie.
Nah, facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Need Weatherall out.
Like, Niggas gotta realize something, homie. You know, when we in the streets hustling, homie, we don't have no vision, bro. We don't really have no vision. We just trying to get money.
Yeah.
Man, but the news people will make you a monster.
Yeah.
It's the same thing with the industry, homie. The industry right now can make you a boogeyman.
Yeah.
They can literally create something and make you a fucking boogeyman. Nigga, you are such and such. You run this, you run that. They can make you that, homie.
Now facts.
But the people behind the camera, they knowing what they doing, homie. They can make you or destroy you.
Ooh, not for real.
They can make you or destroy you, homie.
For real. Damn, real
shit. And I'm just keeping it real, homie.
That's real shit.
You know what I'm saying?
That's real shit.
Why I say what I say, man. And I don't knock the industry, homie. I just wish that it could be more niggas to get that money and we could come together, man.
Fact.
Fuck if I don't care about how much money you got, homie. Niggas will sit around and be like, say, bro, man, that nigga Charles, he be on this. I'm like, man, I'm proud of my nigga, homie.
Yeah.
I want to see my nigga win. Yeah. I want to see, homie, I want to see my nigga win. My nigga, you want me to play quarterback? I'm going to play it.
There you go.
My nigga, you want me to play running back? I'll play it.
There you go.
I even play a little lineman.
Nigga.
If it going to take us to win, homie.
There you go.
You ain't got too many niggas like that.
Nah, it's crazy.
Everybody want to go out for quarterback.
It's crazy because the knowledge that you have, the game that you spit, again, is game related. It teaches us something. I believe even Charles White brother just got out, right?
31 years,
just touched down. Even like talking to him, or I don't know if he's doing interviews yet, but even the knowledge that he could give from inside what happened on the inside is so needed to teach these young niggas to go a certain route, a certain way. Like Charleston said, he used to glorify prison. Like, nigga, that shit was something I looked up to. Nigga, I wanted to go to prison. We used to do shit to say, yeah, I'm in there with my niggas. And it's like, we need to hear these stories. This real shit.
Real shit.
This
man.
Real shit to let niggas know, nah, glorified or not, I'm going to tell you what's really going on. Now, if you want it, you want it. But I'm going to tell you what's really going on, nigga. This is it. So it's a blessing to have you be able to come here and tell this real shit for
I
real.
I did time with Charleston brother on Beto.
Oh, damn.
Before I came home, I did time with him, right? That nigga was a goddamn fool. that nigga used to come down the hallway. And you got to realize, I'm at the end of my bead. You know what I'm saying? And I used to be like, my nigga, y'all niggas is fucking crazy. Man, don't never come out of place over here to holler at me, my nigga. God damn, man, them niggas were wild, homie. Yeah. Them niggas were wild, man.
But was it, did prison make them wild, or you feel like this nigga was already on that shit?
But I'm gonna tell you what prison will do, homie. Some people become institutionalized, and some people got to adapt to their surroundings.
Yeah.
The shit you do in the world, you can't do in prison. Yeah. So let's get that overstood.
Facts.
So my motherfucker be like, and you know, it's a saying to say this here. Man, you better leave that street shit out there and adapt to this shit.
Yeah.
It's totally different. It's totally different, homie. You hear me?
Yeah.
Niggas, you get out, if you in your house, you get out of the shower, you will grab your towel, tie your towel around you, right?
Yeah, simple.
That's normal shit.
Normal shit.
Right? You go to the showers and you tie the towel around you and do that, man, them niggas gonna say, ooh, that nigga hoe.
God damn.
You get what I'm saying?
Just to tie your shit up. Shit.
Nigga, you got a dress on.
Damn.
You see how that shit is mentally?
Hey, bro, you just painted a picture. I'm like, God damn. Some as simple as what you do at home.
Some as simple as what you do at home, my nigga. Shit. Nigga, when you brush your teeth, right? You supposed to brush your teeth and spit in the sink, right?
Yeah.
If you in the penitentiary, you brush your teeth and you spit in that sink, nigga, y'all gonna be squabbling with your cellar, nigga.
For what?
Nigga, the sink is supposed to stay clean. Oh. Because that sink is what we cook at and stuff like that. So when you brushing your teeth, nigga, you need to brush your teeth. You got to spit in the toilet. Yeah, nigga, get wild. And you got to spit in the goddamn toilet, nigga. That's not normal. So you don't think that'll fuck up a nigga? When a nigga sitting in that goddamn cell, and your cellie tell you, say, my nigga, hey, listen, when you brush your teeth, make sure you spit in the toilet, man. You look at this nigga like, what? Say, nigga, because I cook in here, this is what I do, my nigga. Don't you know? You sitting there like, God damn, nigga, what the fuck? Where the fuck am I at? This the type of shit that motherfucker gotta realize. And that there is a culture shock, homie. Right around 2 or 4, that's a culture shock. Just think about it, homie. So they making normal shit unnormal. Normal shit that you literally do out here is unnormal. When you come home after doing all those years, you gotta try to go back to the normal shit.
How long does it take you to readjust?
Man, it gonna take some time, homie. Shit, you gotta realize it took me some time. I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. I sat there, homie, and it took me some time. And I sat there, man, I had to go through it, homie. Because one thing about being down there, You think you know every goddamn thing. You think you know everything. Niggas will sit around and talk and think they done read all these goddamn me done going books. They done read all the all these books, 48 Laws of Power. They done read the Quran. They done read the Bible. Yeah. They done read all these books. Guess what? They think they know every goddamn thing. Yeah. Until it's time to come here and don't none of that shit work. And don't none of that shit work.
Preach.
When you come home, don't none of that shit work, homie. Because guess what you didn't know? Man, listen, nigga. First of all, nigga, you need to get your credit together.
Yeah.
You need to get you some goddamn money. And
right.
It ain't gonna be easy.
Right.
Nigga, when you get you, if you get you a girl, nigga, when you get say, nigga, she wanna go out to eat. She want this, she want, listen. Now you arguing. Oh, we forgot about the stress in there. Yeah, all that. Homie. Yeah. I remember when I was locked up, I said this shit, right? I said, God, let me go home. I'm ready to stress about the world shit. I'm tired of this shit.
Yeah. Give me that word.
And now I'm here. And the motherfucker be like, damn, dude, man, you did like this none. I'm like, my nigga, I asked for this. I'd rather stress about this shit than that shit. Mm. I'd rather get mad. I'm cool, homie. Yeah. I'm cool, my nigga. That's why I'm different, homie.
That's
why I'm totally different, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know,
goddamn.
Man, that's why I say, man, niggas ain't speaking this real shit no more.
Niggas ain't speaking this real shit, man. That's why, again, we glad you're here. We glad you're able to give it to us, man. We glad you're able to run through it because niggas gonna sit back and dissect this shit like a motherfucker and be like, nigga, ain't number real spill coming out this motherfucker way for real.
I ain't bullshitting.
Man, dude, for those that do want to fuck, man, listen, again, Coach P, QC reposted you.
Yeah. You
spit
too much game, bro.
The game you spit is.
You might have to double back on this one.
Yeah, man, nigga. The game you spit is goddamn. It might be too real for fucking TV, man. But for those that do want to follow you, we do want to know, like, the game related, podcast.
Not game related.
Yeah, not game related. Yeah, it's just game related. Tell us again, because I want them to feed into what you got going on, because again, it's only real shit over here. Tell them what you have coming up. Tell them what you got going on. Tell them where they could, you know, catch
shit. Right now, man, me and Charleston White, we got the game related podcast, man. We laying down a bunch of game over there, man. I got my own page, man, which is, you know, my name, Anthony Dewberry official page on YouTube. Then I just created a page last week, the Unbelievable Prison Stories, right?
Ooh.
And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start kind of going into depth on a lot of stories that a lot of people don't really know about. So I'm gonna kind of go into a lot of depth on that. So
don't
I just created that page.
Don't scare them.
Nah, I want them to get knowledge, man.
There you go.
Because, you know, I remember they used to have Skirt Scrape come through prison.
Yeah,
and used to have niggas on the West Night. I'm gonna get you, but
all that shit, yeah.
And I tell people all the time, like, I never was into that shit, homie. I don't want to scare you. I'd rather give you the knowledge. So when you go in there, you better understand what's happening.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? Is there some boogeymans in there? You got doggone right.
Yeah.
There's some boogeymans in there, homie. Like, don't get, I don't want nobody to make it like now, nah, homie.
There's niggas like, what's his name? Fleece Johnson. Like, I see you, I want you.
Homie.
Niggas like that in that bitch?
Man, I swear. Man, I can't say this nigga name, homie, but, man, I know a nigga, man, that nigga yoked up, big dog, nigga. And, you know, he a booty bandit, homie.
Damn.
And that nigga had his own little corner. That nigga had his own goddamn corner, man.
Damn, his own corner?
He called it the saloon.
Damn. Damn, okay.
Man, that nigga called that bitch the saloon. That nigga used to sit back there like this. Damn. Yeah, what are you talking?
What the fuck?
Hey. Say, man, I used to trip out on that shit, man. I used to be like, man, this nigga's a goddamn fool. But he get what? The nigga was out the D. So he was my nigga. The nigga, I remember the nigga used to tell me, dude, knock that hoe out, I'm gonna fuck him. I say, man, you tripping, nigga.
What the fuck?
Yeah. That nigga, man, say, homie, like, so.
You better not go to sleep.
So it was some fucked up, like, this shit was really going on. Like, this shit, like, we talking about this shit right now, right? Yeah. And I be saying to myself, like, nigga, this shit was crazy.
I gotta go home.
So the objective was just not to get knocked out, basically.
Man, the definition is don't go to the penitentiary.
God damn.
You hear me?
Yeah. I gotta go home.
Now I'm home and square business, man.
I gotta get home.
Man, that's why I say, man, you know, so I seen so much of that bullshit, homie.
Yeah.
I seen so much of that bullshit.
Yeah.
So.
Unbelievable prison.
Man, I'm just dropping this shit on the ground, homie.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I, like I said, I'm not glorifying this shit, but I want to say the real shit. You like the rappers talk about streets and how much work they put in and all that? Them same motherfucker went to the penitentiary. They ain't talking about that.
They're not.
You know why? Because a lot of them niggas were doing some strange things. You hear me?
Damn.
Let's keep it real, though.
Stranger things. Stranger things.
That's all I'm saying, man. And you know, it's so fucked up. Remember you asked me about, is Gunna going to come home and be...
Yeah.
He's going to be all that, right?
Yeah, he's going to make it.
Well, this go back to this, right? I know females out here right now that's fucking with niggas that's booty bandits.
Damn. Don't expose them.
Right. But listen to the game, though.
Shit.
But listen to the game, right? Listen to the game, though. A lot of females be like, oh, no. But listen what I'm going to tell you. If you find out that nigga that's been fucking you a booty bandit, you ain't going to do nothing. Because you know why?
Talk to
him. I'm going
to
tell y'all, you know why?
Talk to him.
Man, that nigga been taking care. That nigga money got long. That nigga goddamn be putting that dick down. That nigga taking care of the house. He done did. So I always say this here, right? I seen this nigga at Walmart. I'm going to tell y'all this story before we go. I'm going to say this shit, right? I seen the nigga at Walmart when I got out. I had just got out the penitentiary, my nigga. I'm walking in Walmart. I see this nigga. He seen me. He said, dude, what's up, my nigga? Then what he said to me. I seen him, and in my mind, this nigga's excited to see me, like, and I'm looking at this nigga like, hey, what's up, my nigga? He said, this my wife, man. This my daughter. You know what I'm saying, man? Woo, woo, woo. Then what he telling me, right? I'm like, already, that's what's up, my nigga. Right?
Yeah.
Now, let's rewind.
Yeah.
The nigga, he from my hood, too. The nigga, right, came to the penitentiary. Like I said, nigga don't say no hoes. I had a partner, ran up in his house. Took all his shit.
Yeah.
To see if this nigga gonna stay down. Nigga came in, seen all his shit gone. Say, nigga, man, somebody got my shit. So my nigga was like, bitch, you need to go down and find him. You need to go tell him nigga see what's happening.
Yeah.
The nigga walked in the day room. Say, man, we one of you hoe ass, gangster conversation. Say, man, we one of you hoe ass nigga went in my motherfucking house, man, and got my shit, nigga. You hear me? Like I said, it's a play to see this nigga gonna stay down. My nigga say, nigga, I took your shit, bitch ass nigga. When the door roll, I'ma fall up in your cell, nigga. The door roll, he fell up in the cell. My nigga beat the shit out of him. The nigga screamed over the room, man, I'm a hoe.
Damn.
Right? Down below, it's another nigga from the hood. Old school nigga. Shot word up there to the nigga. Say, man, I want him. Now, guess what? He started getting dick down. Now, he getting fucked. Okay? Now, we gonna come all the way back. I see this same nigga at the goddamn Walmart with his wife. So, I'm sitting there saying to myself, with the girl I was with, I say, baby. And I explained to her what happened. I said, am I wrong for telling the wife what happened? She said, man, leave that nigga alone. I said, you right. Because my thing is, man, listen. What you gonna hear? Oh, that nigga ain't nothing but a hater. Oh, hating ass nigga. That, you gonna hear that, right? Oh, hating ass nigga. You gonna hear all that shit, right? Now I can come back and show you all the nigga that was older and the nigga that gonna tell you the same thing. The female still gonna tell me, oh, hey, man, nigga. And guess what? I choose to stay out these nigga business. Nigga, if you nigga were getting digged down and you nigga were messing with them boys and you girls still wanna fuck with them, hey, that's y'all business.
Man, talk to him.
That's why I tell y'all. Y'all want these big old stocky niggas? Y'all want these niggas that come out the penitentiary? Y'all better start doing the background check. I'm giving y'all some game. Them niggas got them good waves. Them niggas with them big waves in their head, it's stocky. They look good.
Free game.
Please do a background check. I had waves too. My shit gone now though.
Talk to him.
Yeah. I used to have them big old thick motherfuckers.
Goddamn. Same. Harvey type shit.
Give it. I told my girl, I'd rather lose my goddamn hair before I lose my mind in this bitch.
Nah, it is what it is,
nigga. I'm here, Jack.
Hey, he back home. He back home, man. Game related. Goddamn it, Anthony Dewberry on all platforms. Anywhere else they can see you, anywhere else they can follow you, you know what I'm saying?
That's it, man.
You're normally on tour, Charleston, so they could probably see you in person. If Charleston's there out there in y'all city, Dewberry probably gonna be right there somewhere in the background, somewhere in the black ground, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, y'all gonna see me, man. You know, I'll take pictures, y'all take pictures and shit like that. Yeah.
So, there you go.
Thumbs up, man.
Any shout outs you wanna give, Dewberry?
Well, man, I wanna give a shout out to y'all, man. For really, you know, letting the motherfucker really just spread this game without being a rapper. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, isn't that crazy that that's a new wave?
That's a new wave, homie.
Yeah, y'all really kind of started that shit.
Homie, we've been kicking in doors, man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Rappers trying to be y'all. Niggas trying to tell your stories.
I even heard Boosie say, man, I'd rather do a podcast than go to a club.
Nah, facts.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm saying myself, like, shit. Man, shout out to y'all, man.
Nah, love.
You know what I'm saying? For letting us goddamn me share this game.
Nah, love.
What we putting out. You know I got to always give a shout out to, man, my family, man. You know what I'm saying? LBR the mob, man. Shout out to LBR, man. Free my guys, man. Man, they good, man. They good. Good spirit, man. So I want to give a major shout out to them, homie. You know what I'm saying? They'll be free soon, man.
That's good.
Big bro, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I got to give a shout out to the real ones, man, that's been rocking with me, man. You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
You know how we rocking, man. You know, we're going to keep putting it down. Say, man, I appreciate y'all, man.
Nah, we appreciate you, for real.
I really want to, like I said, there's so much that can be done.
Yeah, like you said, with the...
You know what I'm saying?
I fuck with kids.
From the bloggers to
you look like a teacher, man.
We want to touch
with the kids and give them hope and give them goals outside of being a rapper or a ball player.
Yeah,
and just show them that there's other ways to get it. You know what I'm saying? So definitely we need to tap in. So even, you know, let us, if there's something that you, if you and C Dub got something going on,
yeah,
and y'all need some camera crews or just real life in the building. Please let us know. You know what I'm saying? We all about giving back. So, definitely. That's love for real, man. I can't say it enough, Dewberry, man. It's coming from a real place, man.
Another internet sensation.
Goddamn, where's Dallas Legend? Goddamn it, man. Wait till Netflix come in the goddamn building. Go get the whole story.
What?
Big Dewberry in the goddamn building.
Come on, man.
Hey, goddamn it. We got Big Anthony in the building. You are a real life street star. Salute that shit, man, for real.
It ain't real life. Just a real life street star.